add a quiz. Click on add an activity. Quiz is an activity. Click on activities. So there is option. Quiz is available. We can give the quiz. Click on that. It will need a name. Say that this is the test number 1. We'll give the description. We have to specify the timing. When our quiz will open and when our quiz will close. So now we are not giving any time. You can enable this time limit. Our quiz is having a 60 minute time. Open attempts are submitted automatically. This option is by default. We have to choose the same one. Grades. The grades are uncategorized for this. And attempts, we are attempting or we are giving only one attempt to the students. Layout. For each page, how much questions you want. So we'll take every 5 questions per page. So suppose 20 mark question, 20 questions. So we have a 4 pages with 5 questions on each page. Next is question behavior, shuffle with the question, yes, and default feedback. Review option. So we are not showcasing or not providing the marks to the student when they are giving the exam. After submission of the quiz and when the quiz is finished for all the students, then we are displaying the grades. Choose only last option, that after the quiz is closed, we are giving all the options. But in between the quiz, we are not providing anything. Deselect all the checkboxes. Shows the appearance. Shows the user's picture. So no picture, decimal places needed to save exam browser. So there is no need. Okay, for this time, we need this much of options. So click on save and display. So what it says, that attempts allowed only one. Time limit is 1 hour, but no questions has been added yet. The first thing, we have to add the question. So there are two different methods. By using that method, so we can add the question. First method, we will directly add the questions manually. Or second, we can add bulk questions. We'll choose a bulk question option. How we can insert? So click on unit number 1 again. Click on test number 1. Here is the gear icon. Click on that icon. What it shows? It shows some settings. So group override, user override, edit quiz, preview, results, grades, statistics, and all the things. What we needed? We needed to add the questions. So we are importing the questions to this test. Import option. Click on that. So there are more number of options available that file formats. The first is ICANN format, Blackboard format, embedded answers, exam view, GIFT format, and missing word format, Moodle XML format, and WebCity format. But now for this session, we are going to cover only one format, that is ICANN format. So we'll click on this format and choose a file. So I have already provided the ICANN format file in the description. So you can take that format as it is. I have created a question by using ICANN format. I will just upload this. After that, I will show you how this ICANN format is. So this is the test 1 paper. So test 1 and upload this file. Next, we have to provide import. So it shows that the importing 20 questions from the file. So 20 questions we have added to the quiz. And we have to click on continue. Right. So now, for this default for RPFM, this is the course name. And for this course, we have added the test number 1, and which is having a 20 question. But currently, we have not added any questions to the quiz. So next topic, again click on unit number 1. Click on test number 1. Click on edit quiz. So we have to add. From where we have to add? We have to add a new question manually or from question bank or a random question. We have already created a question bank under the course name, that is RPFM. So from question bank. So So it will show the default to RPFM or default to any course. Yes, so default to RPFM, we want. These are the 20 questions available. Select. So click on this icon. Select all and add selected questions to the quiz. It will add all the questions to the quiz. It again showing the option that is shuffle. So click on that option, shuffle. Maximum grades. So maximum grades for 20 questions, we are giving the 20 marks, 1 mark per question. We'll click on the save. Next is, we have to check whether our test is assigned, that is correct or not. For that, we have to take the preview. So click again on unit number 1. You can now turn editing off. For students, it is look like this. That's under the announcement, it is having a syllabus of RPFM. Unit number 1 contains 3 videos with test 1. So click on test number 1, we have to check the preview. So we can directly attempt that, or here is the gearbox, click on that and click on preview. Because you are a teacher or you are an administrator, so you can preview the questions before giving to the students. So click on start attempt. Per page 5 questions. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 questions. Now, and timing we are given, that is 60 minutes. We'll just select options and we'll click on the next page. After that, again we'll choose some option. And suppose user want that I want to submit the test, so he can go to the next page after again finish the attempts. So it shows that summary, answered questions and unanswered questions, not yet answered, likewise. So for this time we have to submit all the and submit all and finish. So it shows that you have finished the test. When you start the test, when you complete the test, time taken, that is 1 minute 5 seconds, how much time user has given or user has take to give the exam. So in this way we have added the questions.